Hi guys, welcome back to another informative video where we discuss things about saving, investing, stock market, and a lot of practical tips that you can use to improve your way of living. I'll be uploading some lifestyle and travel contents from time to time since now that I have reached more than 1K subscribers. I want people and I want my subscribers to get to know me more. So I'll be uploading lifestyle and travel contents from time to time. Pero we'll stick, of course, to the main topic na ganito and sit down discussions because I know most of you guys went here for that. Wala na para lang karon ng variations, 'di ba? Yung ano natin, yung video. So I uploaded one yesterday. So ayun, shinare ko lang. Okay, for today's topic, we'll be discussing the 7 millennial mindsets you should practice. You know what, as a millennial, we are in this era na hati tayo. You know, we were able to experience the things na traditional, and we were also able to experience when the world entered the digital world, right? Because in my case, I was able to do some laro pa when I was young, katulad ng mga patintero, Chinese garter, piko, alam mo yun, lahat yun na naranasan ko when I was young. And I have a really, really good childhood. Tapos yun din yung time na umuuso yung mga PlayStation, Game Boy, alam mo yun. So, millennials, I think, would, especially kung nanonood ka as millennial ka, andun tayo sa era na yun eh, na parang we were able to experience the beauty of both worlds. Alam mo yun? We were able to ride along, we were able to see the good and bad, we were able to see the rise and fall of some of the brands. And it's very important as a millennial that you embrace some mindsets, considering we were able to experience those in the past. Actually, if I'll be asked, yun siguro yung nakakapanghinayang doon sa mga younger generation because of the pandemic. Yung iba, syempre, hindi nila ma-enjoy yung childhood nila. Yun ako nalulungkot for some. So, those are the things that we will be discussing today. First, lalo na kung nandun ka sa mga 20s na age and you are working, this video is for you. Number one is to run your own race. You have to understand that we have different timelines and that we have different field. Nakakatawa kasi minsan, may mga ibang tao, uy, ang galing niya naman, nakuha niya na to, or uy, ang galing niya naman. Kasi, you know, there are certain professions that would take time. Say, for example, being a lawyer, being a doctor, I have friends na bagot na sila sa law school. Naiinis na sila sa med school because the field that they entered, ganun talaga. It would take time. Unlike yung mga taong tapos na sa 4-year course nila, pwede na silang magtrabaho, pwede na silang bumili ng ganito, etc., etc. The people who are still studying because they have graduate school or yung field and profession na pinili nila, ganun katagal, talagang nafe-feel nila na napag-iwanan na sila or sometimes nahihiya na sila sa parents nila kasi they're still dependent sa kanila. So, don't ever feel that you have to compete with others. Make sure that you are running your own race. May sarili kang karera. So, focus there. You at the end of the day, it's you disciplining yourself not to look and not to compare yourself from others. Kasi iba ka ng field. Baka kasi kinukumpara mo yung sarili mo, lawyer ka or aspiring doctor ka, ganyan. Tapos kinukumpara mo yung sarili mo dun sa mga taong tapos na mag-aral. Or yung iba naman, may board exam, tas yung isa tapos na. You know, we have different timelines. I really believe in that. And you have to always listen to God's purpose. Hindi pwedeng yung gusto mo lang masusunod. Dapat yung gusto niya rin, tignan mo rin at pakinggan mo rin. Yon. Next. Write down concrete plans. Ito yung madalas na hindi ginagawa ng mga tao may nakasama sa age group ko eh. They are not writing down concrete plans. Have you noticed before, yung mga magulang natin, gusto ko umaman, ang sagot na nila is tumaya sa loto. But at this stage of our lives, we have to write down concrete plans. Dapat kung may gusto kang ma-achieve, you put there quantifiable and action points kung paano mo ma-reach yung goal mo. Because you will never jump from point A to B kung wala nasa gitna yung plano kung paano ka makadiretso dun sa point B na gusto mo. So it's important that you write down concrete plans. Huwag mong hayaan na kainin ka lang na kasi gusto mo siya, but you are not being strategic about it. So always remember, if there's something that you want to achieve, what are the things you want to do? What are the things you think would, what would it take for you to get there? So, lagi yun actionable dapat. Hindi pwedeng nandyan lang siya na gusto mo mayaman but you are not increasing your passive income. Or you're still stuck in the same place or wala kang emergency fund, wala kang ipon. So, you need to take action. Next, Next, look at valuable companies to work for. Kasi alam nyo, yung mga companies, let's face it, if you are an ordinary person at gusto mo magnegosyo, papaano ka makakapagsimula kung wala kang capital? So at some point, you have to really work for someone in a company. Paanohin mo yung skills mo, tapos parabihin mo yung network mo para you can get out of your corporate job and you can have your own business. I've read that in the books of Robert Kiyosaki. So if you are the type of person na talagang maraming ideas, full of ideas ka, tapos marami kang gustong projects na simulan, in order for you to jump into business, kakailanganin mo ng capital. And in order for you to do that, you really need to work for it and save up for your capital. May mga iba talagang sineswerte. Hindi naman mawawala yan sa buhay yung mga taong swerte talaga na nagsimula lang ng ganito at an early age tapos nag-boom. May mga ganon. But if hindi tayo ganon or hindi tayo kabilang sa mga ganon tao, we really need to move and take action. So, dapat smart tayo about it. Next, make more mistakes. This is my favorite. You know what? Before, takot-takot ako magkamali. Ngayon, I don't care. Up until na mag-reach ako ng 30, I am still capable of committing mistakes. Kasi the higher or the older you are, the responsibilities and yung outlook mo sa buhay nag-iiba eh. And at the same time, yung pananaw ng ibang tao towards sa'yo or pakikisama ng tao kumpara doon nung bata ka pa, iba talaga. So imagine if you have a boss na nasa early 30s or mid-30s siya. Tingin mo, same siya ng pakikitungo doon sa 20s or fresh grad lang. Di ba iba? Because as you get older, nag-iiba-iba talaga yung pananaw. So now that you have time and liberty to commit mistakes and to learn from them, grab those. So huwag kang matatakot na mag-try out ng mga gantong mga bagay or mga bagay na sa simula nakakatakot. And sometimes you would feel ayaw mo siyang gawin kasi you're afraid of the outcome kasi ayaw mo magkamali. No, this is the best time for you to commit mistakes. This is the best time for you to learn from them. Kasi kapag matanda ka na, kapag magkakamali ka, parang ang dami ng nakasalalay or ang dami ng dependent dun sa action mo. So now that you are young, commit as many mistakes as possible para pag lumaki ka na, natutunan mo na siya. Diba? Kesa naman na natatakot ka ngayon magsubok, tapos kung kailan ka naging matanda, doon ka naging sobrang pag-explore. Right? So, yun. Next, learn to multitask. I have a lot of friends who's really bad at multitasking. Ako din, sobrang wala akong masasabi kapag sa multitasking before. But I read books and I try to watch videos on how you can multitask. Alam nyo kasi yung multitasking, for some, iniisip nila tedious. Pero kapag nakuha mo na yung formula kung paano mag-multitask, grabe, you would realize na you have accomplished so much because it's a discipline eh. There's a formula there. So ako, ang ginagawa ko when I multitask, I put limits per task. So while I'm doing it all at the same time, because let's admit it, there's just tasks that you can do at the same time. Meron naman talaga mga pwede kang gawin at once, diba? Na I would say na effective siya. So ako, kapag nagmumultitask ako, I always note it in my notebook kung ano yung mga task and ano yung mga time per each task na gusto ko while I'm doing it all at the same time. Kasi right now, I wanna maximize the time that we are at home and that we can do so much because we can save up the time we are allotting for traffic or for transportation to more valuable things like freelancing or getting clients or selling or an online selling business. So maximize yun. If you are not good at multitasking, read books and watch videos that can teach you how to do and how you can be a good multitasker. So kasi nakakatulong talaga siya. Next, have time for yourself. Most people right now nare-realize nila that they should be investing more on their well-being. Yung iba nag-enter ng different webinars or mental health session, or some will just go on YouTube and watch fitness videos and apply it sa buhay nila or gawin nila from time to time, yung mga 2 weeks shreds. I am also in that part right now and it's a mindset that I wanna practice from time to time. Why? Kasi kung hindi mo aalagaan yung well-being mo, yung wellness mo, mga soon, magte-turn siya into illness. So, we don't want that. We wanna make sure that we take good care of ourselves because after after all, we are the best investment that we can have. So invest in yourself. Skills man yan, sa katawan mo. You know what? Try to go to massage parlor para ma-relax ka. And your face, kesa puro makeup, mag-skincare, o kaya magpa-facial treatment. Because for sure, a lot of things na-accumulate na ng mukha mo sa junks. Yung mga kahit nasa bahay ka lang minsan kasi marami pa rin alikabok and all. So, you know what? From time to time, check on yourself. Magkaroon ka ng assessment sa sarili mo. Next, never forget to save. This is the last part. I think a lot of people would have realized this at this point. We are on our second year of lockdown and makikita mo talaga yung mga taong iponado at mga taong marunong mag-impok dahil ngayong panahon ng pandemic, meron silang pera, hindi sila nang ihingi, hindi sila yung tipong isang kahig isang tuka na hindi alam kung saan kukunin ng pera kasi may naipon. So if you are a millennial and kunyari nasa mid-20s ka or early-20s ka or late-20s ka ba, it's very important that you save regardless if ano ka, nasa anong position ka dun. Kahit pa nag-30s ka, always make sure that you save up for your future, for something that you wanna buy, for your future family, for your emergency fund. Never forget to put a portion of your money to savings. Kasi importante siya. So yun, those are my 7 millennial mindsets that you need to practice. And nag-enjoy ako. I didn't know na ang bilis o, natapos agad siya na in 10 minutes. So, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. And please, don't forget to subscribe. We are nearing our 3K. So yun, thank you!